Welcome one and all to today's meeting of Liverpool City Combined Authority, which contains the annual meeting for 2018-19. First of all, welcome Councillor Gray Morgan, who is the leader of the councils in his first meeting. Welcome. And also to our deputy portfolio holders to their first meeting. Hopefully we'll see you on a regular basis. It's great to have you here today. It would be remiss of me not to mention that 3-1 result. I am, of course, referring to Liverpool City Region's football team that was victorious last night against Manchester City Region's Combined Authority team. And the game itself was played on behalf of homeless charities in both cities, and so the money raised would be split between us and them. And that's all I have to say on football. On behalf of the Combined Authority, I'm sure that the leaders would endorse this. Can I send our best wishes to Mike Paylor for a speedy recovery from his current illness, and hope to see him back here when he seems fit. Can I also ask everybody to ensure that they turn off their phones, and when you do speak, you can speak as closely as possible to the mics, because people in the public galleries have problems sometimes hearing. Welcome to Calm. Are there any apologies for absence through?
I've received apologies from Councillor Moore, Steve Hammett, Jane Kennedy, Reverend Cannon Loudon, Barbara Spicer, Gideon Benthoven, Sarah Wild McCowan, Lynn Collins, and Councillor Nicholas.
Anything to add? Item 2 is declarations of interest from any members.
I haven't received any, Chair.
3 is an update of the constitution, and the Combined Authority constitution needs to be regularly updated. Jane Bakewell is going to briefly take us through this item.
Thank you. The Interim Monitoring Officer has carried out an annual review of the constitution, and the report sets out the proposed amendments at paragraph 2.1. The changes are merging the Audit Committee, the existing Audit Committee and Standards Committee in Part 3 of the Constitution to create a new Audit and Governance Committee, with substitute members being proposed to that new committee. Part 8 is to be deleted, which is the statutory orders, which are actually on the website, and a new definition of lead officers. Those are the recommendations in paragraph 2.1.
Okay, and Jan very graciously didn't pick me up on this pronunciation of her name. Thank you very much for that. All the recommendations are set out in the report on page 1, agreed.
Agreed.
Item 4 is the Combined Authority nominations for 2018-19. We have an updated version that apparently has been distributed to people in the chamber. Frank's going to take us through the first part of this report.
Thank you, Chair. I'll pick up the instructions to the report. I'll pass it to the Chair to pick up items 3 to 7 on the membership, and then I'll pick up item 8 with relation to officers. So this report is just to outline nominations to the Combined Authority following the annual meetings of each of the authorities in the district. So I'll hand over to Steve to pick up the membership of the Combined Authority and the nominations to portfolio.
Okay, so following those annual meetings, the constituent councils have advised their appointments of members to the Combined Authority, and their nominations to committees are as follows. So, Holton is Councillor Rapoa with a substitute, Councillor Mike Wharton. Knowsley is Councillor Gray Morgan with Councillor Donnelly as a substitute. Liverpool is Mayor Joanne Sinobie and Councillor Wendy Simon. Sefton is Councillor Ian Mayer and Councillor John Fairclough. St Helens is Councillor Derek Long and Councillor Bowden as a substitute. And Whittles is Councillor Phil Davis and Councillor George Davis as a substitute. In regard to, and the Local Enterprise Partnership have appointed Asif Hamid, and the substitute has yet to be confirmed to us. Associate members, Warrington appointed Councillor Tony O'Neill, Terry O'Neill, and Councillor R. Bowden. West Lancs is Councillor Moran and Councillor McKenna, and the non-voting members are Liam Robinson, the right honourable Jane Kennedy from the Merseyside Basin County Commissioner, and the appointment of portfolio holders. That has been circulated, but it is as thus. Business growth and Brexit is Asif Hamid. Inclusive growth, economic development, digital and innovation is Councillor Davis. Energy and renewables is Councillor Pohill. Culture, tourism and a visitor economy is Mayor Anderson. Public service reform and further devolution is Councillor Morgan. Education, employment, apprenticeships and skills is Councillor Mayer. Housing and spatial planning is Councillor Long. Policy and resource, strategy and delivery is Mayor Rotherham. Transport and air quality is the chair of the Transport Committee, which is Councillor Robinson. And criminal justice is the Right Honourable Jane Kennedy. On the appointment of deputy portfolio holders, the portfolios mirror the leaders' portfolios. So it's inclusive growth, etc. is Councillor Neil. Energy and renewables is Councillor Wood. Culture, etc. is Councillor Powell. Public service reform and further devo is Councillor Sinnott. Education, etc. is Councillor Robinson Collins. Housing spatial is Councillor Hardy. Policy and resource, etc. is Councillor Thomas. Transport and air quality is Councillor Nicholas, and criminal justice is Councillor Spurrell.
Thank you, Chair. I'll pick up from section 8. As members are aware, the combined authority staff and structure is still being developed. While that's ongoing, it's considered that it's important that the newly appointed combined authority officers pick up the role of lead officers, but that it's critical that they continue to work collaboratively and in consultation with the chief executives of the constituent authorities. There has been an amendment to section 8 as a consequence of agreements that have been reached. It's now going to be the case that the chief executives of the individual districts will be aligned to the portfolios that their leaders or mayor are responsible for. So we will be coming back to the June meeting with a revised table under section 8, given the appointment of the consistent local authority chief executive roles against each of the portfolios that their leaders hold. But from a CA officer's perspective, in relation to the interim head of paid service, I've been picked up by myself, Frank Rogers. Treasurer is John Fogarty, the director of corporate services, the combined authority. From a governance perspective, it's Jill Poole, who commences as monitoring officer with effect from the 2nd of July. Scrutiny will be Kirsty Pearce, the Director of Policy and Strategic Commissioner. Business Growth and Brexit will be Mark Bousfield, Director of Commercial Development and Investment. Similarly, Inclusive Growth, Economic Development, Digital and Innovation will be Mark Bousfield. Culture, Tourism and the Visitor Economy will be Kirsty Pearce, Director of Policy and Strategic Commissioner. Energy and Renewables will be myself, Frank Rogers. Housing and Spatial Planning is also Kirsty Pearce. Transport and air quality will be picked up by Mick Noon, Director of Integrated Transport. Education, employment, apprenticeships and skills will be picked up by Kirsty Pearce, as will public service reform and further devolution. Criminal justice will be picked up by myself, Frank Rogers, as will policy and resources, strategy and delivery. As I say, we'll bring the paper back to the June CA confirming the district chief executive appointments in support of those roles.
Can we agree the recommendations are set out on the updated report? Item 5 is covers appointments to committees of the Combined Authority. Again, we've got an updated schedule following the council meetings, and Jan is going to take us through this report.
Thank you, Chair. The updated report lists the appointments to the committees for approval. Those positions that are left to be confirmed will be brought back to a future meeting of the Combined Authority. The appointments are listed in 3.1 for Overview and Scrutiny Committee, on page 220 for Transport Committee, Audit and Governance Committee, and Appointments and Disciplinary Committee. and they're for approval, Chair.
Okay, can we agree the appointments are set out in the updated report?
Agreed.
Six, again, Jan's going to take us through the timetable of the meetings.
Chair, the updated report sets out the dates of the various meetings for noting and diarising and approval by the CA.
Okay. Is the updated timetable of meetings agreed?
Agreed.
Seven is appointments to external organisations, and Jan again is going to take us through the report. Following a recent request from Christmas, has been proposed that two substitute members also be appointed to the Christmas board.
Thank you, Chair. The report requests appointments to be made to a number of external bodies. Those are listed in 2.1. For noting, Chair, at paragraph 3.2, the Liverpool City Council representative is to be amended. That's what's stated in the report currently, and that is to be Councillor Gary Miller. Instead, the recommendations are in 2.1, Chair, for approval.
Okay, taking on board the additional recommendations, can we agree those recommendations set out on page 225, please?
Agreed.
Eight is a presentation which reviews the combined authorities' progress over the last year, which I'll start, Frank can add to, and anybody else who believes that they want to add anything to it. So, as you can see, we made significant. Oh, remember the video first? Yeah, fine. Okay, we're going to show a short video first.